Hello and welcome everyone. I'm so glad that we are meeting again. In the seventh video of Computer Systems and Organization Part 1, today we are going to learn secondary memory or auxiliary memory. Let's begin. Secondary memory or auxiliary memory or auxiliary storage or secondary storage or external memory, they are the same. They are used to store a large amount of data at lesser cost per byte than primary memory. Then you have secondary memory for that. They are less expensive than primary memory. And the most common types are flash memory. In flash memory, we have pen drive, optical disk, we have CD, DVD, Blu-ray disk, magnetic disk, we have hard disk, magnetic tapes, etc. So these three are the common type of secondary memory devices which we use in our day-to-day life also. You must be using pen drive or something. You must have seen pen drives in your life, flash memory. Pen drives are an electronic non-volatile computer storage device that can be electrically erased and reprogrammed and works without any moving parts. So, pen drives, they can store large amount of data and they are portable in nature. How it looks like? Pen drives like this. You must have observed, we always say that, do you have a USB pen drive? USB stands for Universal Serial Bus. Do you have a USB pen drive like that? So, USB pen drives. Pen drives are of great help to us, and they come in variety of storage capacity, like 16 GB, 8 GB, 32 GB pen drives, and even nowadays you can see 100 GB pen drives and even more. Coming on to next, optical disk device, optical storage device. Optical disk is a storage medium from which data is read and to which you can write by lasers. Optical disks can store much more data, up to 6 gigabytes. Then most portable magnetic media such as floppies or... Floppies are nowadays obsolete though. Floppies, you must have seen the shape is square shaped floppy, inside that round platters are there, magnetic tapes used to be there. Anyways, so floppies are nowadays obsolete, so we won't go into the details of that. What we have in optical is CD, compact disc, DVD, digital optical disc storage, or a digital video disc, or digital versatile disc, Blu-ray disc. They are also digital optical discs. Now CD can be divided into three parts: CD-ROM, CD-R and CD-RW. CD-ROM is compact disc read-only memory. You must have seen many CDs which you get in the market very cheaply, where you can get games or already loaded songs. They are CD-ROM, where you cannot write anymore. It's already written there. The information is already written. CDR, compact disc recordable. Here you must have observed that when your teacher asks you to submit a project, what you do is you buy a CDR, you store your PPTs or your files or any information on CDR, compact disc recordable, you submit that. Once you write on that CDR, you cannot write any more on that. You can now read only. So CDR, you can write once, but you can read many times, multiple times you can read. So it becomes like a ROM after writing once. That is after storing information once on CDR. And next is CDRW, compact disc rewritable. So as many times you can write on that you can erase, you can again edit, you can again write on the CDRW, you can write multiple times, you can store multiple times in CDRW, you can erase, you can edit. So you can do that, you can read write, you can keep on going doing like that. So CDRW is that. In the same way with higher capacity, you have DVD, which was initially invented and developed by Moser Bear and Philips, Sony, Toshiba, Panasonic in 1995. You have heard these terms. We have heard first in 1995 DVD has got higher capacity than CDs, of course, and again it can be divided into three parts: DVD ROM, DVD R and DVD RW, the same way as I have explained CD. Only the capacity is more, and Blu-ray disc, it has got much more capacity than DVDs. So DVD has got more capacity than CDs, and Blu-ray disc have got more capacities than DVD, and they can store data on both sides of the disc. The single layer disc can hold a data of 25 GB. So on both sides you can have 25 GB and 25 GB, you can have 50 GB of data. So Ultra HD Blu-ray disc is also there, which can store almost 100 GB of data. So 50 GB on either sides. This is how your compact disc, CD and then DVD and Blu-ray disc looks like. DVDs are costlier, they have got higher capacity than CDs, and Blu-ray discs are again costlier than DVDs and got higher capacity also, and can store on both sides. You can store information on both sides. And if you notice, DVDs are very shiny. CDs and DVDs, they are very shiny because they have pits and holes, and we are not going into the details of how information is stored there. So let's move on. We have magnetic media, and in magnetic media we have hard disk, which comes under secondary device. Remember, hard disk is a secondary device. It has got very large capacity. You can see hard disk in the market like this. And if you open one of the sides, you can see like this that there are platters, like as if multiple CDs are kept one on another. It looks like that. Matlab ek ke upar ek CDs rakhne se jaisa hota hai, us kind of a picture you can see. So multiple platters are each rounded shape. This is known as a platter. Disc is known as a platter. So multiple platters are there, and there is a read write head, that is the actuator arm, and through this read write head the data is read and written from the disc and on the disc. And if you see the top view of the hard disk, if you see it from this top, there is from the middle there is a cylindrical shape where multiple platters are kept. Now in the top view you can see that if you can divide the disk platters, you can see tracks and sectors. And let us see what are tracks and sectors. Each disk consists of platters, rings on each side of each platter called tracks. Now this is the innermost track, then the second track, and then the third track. As you have seen tracks in your athletic fields also, where athletes they run, the similar kind, there is a rounded circular tracks, and this is the innermost track, this one is the outermost track. So if you divide the tracks, then you get sectors. How a sector is the smallest physical storage unit, kind of a pie shaped this is pie shaped like if you cut a cake and you get a pie. So kind of that, this is a sector of your track. So if you divide the track into 8 equal parts, you will get sectors, or maybe more sectors you can also get from here. So sector is the smallest physical storage unit on a disk, almost always 512 bytes in size for hard disk drives, HDDs, and 2048 bytes for CD-ROMs and DVD-ROMs. Quite higher in CD-DVD-ROMs. So just have a look of this. Moving on. Yes, this is also an important part to know, the system bus. How the different functional components of a computer system are connected to each other through cables. So these cables are known as actually buses, system bus. So when one device internally is connected to another device through buses, and they provide electronic part to connect major functional components of a computer through these cables. The system bus helps in the passing of data and instructions among the various functional components. And if you divide the system bus, you get four kinds of system buses. Data bus, which carries data actually. Control bus, which controls the instruction, control instruction carrying part of a system, which carries the instructions for how these data will be executed. Those control instructions are sent through control bus. Address bus, they are actually storing the memory addresses, and they send the memory address through these address buses. So these address buses, they carry the memory address from one component to another component. And IO bus, that is, it connects the input, output and other external devices to the system. So again, recap: data bus, control bus, address bus and IO bus. So I hope you have understood how these buses connect these components, like the input is connected to the CPU and then CPU to the memory, and internally all these different paths are connected to each other inside, and these buses, they work here in the total system. So this is all about system bus. Now some extra topic to know: ports in computer system, what are they? Computer ports are actually the connection points or interfaces with which the peripheral devices are connected. Now where these buses or ports, they different components, they get connected to the system, they get connected through these ports. There are two main types of computer ports. One is physical and virtual port. So physical ports are used for connecting a computer through a cable and a socket to a peripheral device. So if we see the physical ports over here, on which we will emphasize here: serial port, we have parallel port, PS2 port, universal serial bus or USB port. USB port, every one of us knows, where we put in the pen drive. Then we have serial port like this, communications port, and parallel port like this, where we join printers. And then we have VGA port, video graphics adapter. Visual graphics adapter here. Then we have PS2 port or mouse port like this, and a keyboard port at the back side of your computer system cabinet. You can see these ports. PS2 keyboard connector is there like this. Keyboard, a violet colored port is there, a green color port. PS2 mouse connector port is there. Then you have audio out jack and line in jack, and your microphone jack is also there, where you can put in your microphone to get connected, and your speakers also you can connect here. So the audio out, USB, there are 2.0 and 2 USB ports are there, that you know. And Ethernet or LAN port, suppose you want to get your system connected to the internet, you have this LAN port or Ethernet port, through which you can put in your RJ45 a connector, where you can put in your patch cord, and then you can get it connected to a switch or a hub, and or your router if you have at home. And if it is a physical connection, then so likewise you can get your system connected to the internet. And then you have serial communications port, parallel port, okay. So we have said about all. And there are other ports also, modem port and then firewire port and power connector. Power connector is definitely there where you put in your power adapter through which your system gets the power. The main thing is, if you have a UPS, uninterrupted power supply, then you connect your UPS with your system so that you can get uninterrupted power supply, and there is your power port where you put in the UPS connector there. And then sockets, accelerated graphics port is there, AGP port, DVI and digital video interface port you have if you want to connect it to suppose a CCTV camera or something. You have DVR port also nowadays. And then AGP accelerated graphics port you have for high level gaming. Anyways, these are a few extra things. You can check out all this in your system. So thank you for now. Give a quick recap of the entire video and come back again. Thank you.